गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल लर्न चैप्टर 6 टिश्यूज। इन लास्ट बायोलॉजी चैप्टर द फंडामेंटल यूनिट्स ऑफ लाइफ यू लर्न अबाउट सेल्स। सेल इज द बेसिक स्ट्रक्चरल एंड फंक्शनल यूनिट ऑफ लाइफ। Yes, cells. So a lot of cells together forms what is called as tissues. Okay. Now, if there are a lot of tissues, different types of tissues, different types of tissues together forms organs. Okay, now many such organs together form organ system, and many organ system together forms organism, right? So in last chapter we have learned about cells, and in this chapter you will learn about tissues. Now, what is a tissue? By definition, the cells which are specialized in function are grouped together and form a tissue. So, many cells having similar function, they group together to form tissues. And what are the main functions of tissues? You will see, they play the role of protection. Next function, they help in control and coordination. Another function is they act as insulators. What do you mean by insulators? Protection from wear and tear. So skin is an insulator in living things. So tissues, we will mainly study about two types of tissues. One is plant tissue and the other is animal tissue. So in this particular video, we will be only dealing about plant tissues. Plant tissues are mainly of two types, meristematic tissue and permanent tissue. What is it? Meristematic tissue and permanent tissue. Meristematic is a new term for you, so you should write and learn these spellings. And the other is permanent tissue. Let us see what they are. Meristematic tissue. These tissues are those which divide continuously throughout life and help in the increasing length and girth of the plant. So what is meristematic tissue? These are certain types of tissues present in plants which keep on dividing, divide, redivide, again divide and divide. So what happens on dividing? The length will increase. And the girth. Girth means overall breadth. That is called girth of the plant will increase. And what is the main characteristic of a meristematic tissue? How does a meristematic tissue looks like? Or how will you identify? They have thin cellulose cell walls. So in last class we learned about cell walls. They are present only in plant cell, right? The outer layer of a cell in plants is called the cell wall. So in meristematic tissues, this cell wall is very thin. You can see a typical meristematic tissue in this figure. Center, you have a nucleus. The brown spots that you see are nucleus, and nucleus is surrounded by cytoplasm, which you have already learned in the last chapter. Second point is, meristematic cells may be spherical, oval, polygonal, or rectangle in shape. The shape varies, right? Meristematic cells, they are, in this figure you can see it is polygonal. In certain other plants you can see it will be spherical. In some other plants the tissues will be oval. In some other plants it will be rectangle. So the shape of these cells may vary. The meristematic cells are compactly arranged. In this figure you can see there is no space in between first cell and second cell. There is no space between second and third and fourth. There is no space at all. So all these cells together compactly packed so that there is no gap in between them. So this is also a characteristic of meristematic tissue. Each meristematic cell contains dense or abundant cytoplasm and a single large nucleus. So that is a characteristic of a cell, right? In meristematic cell also, there is a central nucleus and surrounded by dense cytoplasm. Next characteristic is, meristematic cells contain few vacuoles or no vacuoles at all. We learned vacuoles. Vacuoles are also a characteristic feature of plant cell. So in meristematic tissue also, sometimes vacuoles are found, or sometimes there will not be vacuoles at all. Now, where is this meristematic tissue found? Meristematic tissues are found in three places, and depending upon the place where these tissues are found, it is named as apical meristem, intercalary meristem, and lateral meristem. In apical meristem, as the name suggests, it is found in the apex of the plant. Apex means tip of the plant. Now, intercalary meristem, it is found on the nodes. What is called nodes? These brown colored structure which is showed here is called the node, from where a leaf arises, right? A leaf arises or a stem arises from a node. So this is called node. Yeah, this is one node and this is also another node. So the space in between them is called internode. Internode. So it is node and internode. So if the meristem is found on the nodes, then it is called intercalary meristem. And the third type is lateral meristem, which is found on the sides, lateral sides of the plant. Okay, so there are three types of meristem based upon where it is found: apical meristem, intercalary meristem, and lateral meristem. Apical meristem, as we said, it is present at growing tips of the stems and roots. That is called shoot apex and root apex. Apex means at the tip. And what is the function? It results in the increase of height of the plant. Okay, the height will increase
If the meristem, apical meristem is present, it will increase the height of the plant. So if I cut, if I use a knife and cut this apical meristem, what happens? The length of the plant will not increase. So you can see in gardens and all, if the apical meristem is cut, then this plant will not grow in the length. And next is the lateral meristem. They are found beneath the bark. What is meant by bark? What you find the outer covering of the plant, that is called bark, right? So this lateral meristem is found beneath that. If you remove this covering of this plant, you can find lateral meristem. And what is the function of lateral meristem? It helps in the increasing of diameter. So it will increase the diameter of the plant. Third one is the intercalary meristem. As I already said, it is located at the base or base of leaves, base of the leaves or internodes. So example, stems of grasses. You can see the stems of grasses, they are intercalary meristem. Now function is to increase the number of branches. So if intercalary meristems are present, the number of branches will increase. So next type of tissue is permanent tissue. First we learnt about meristematic tissue. Now permanent tissue. What is the specialty of permanent tissue? These tissues are derived from meristematic tissue. These are formed from meristematic tissue. But main difference is these cells have lost the power of division. In meristematic tissue, we saw that it can divide and redivide, right? But permanent tissue, as the name suggests, it is permanent. It cannot divide or redivide. And permanent tissue are of two types, simple permanent tissue and complex tissues. Simple permanent tissue and complex tissues. Simple permanent tissues, these are tissues which are composed of cells which are structurally and functionally similar. And these tissues are all made up of similar type of cells only. And complex tissues, they consist of more than one type of cell. And they are xylem and phloem. Xylem helps in water transport. In plants, right? And phloem helps in transport of food material. Now simple permanent tissues, they are of three types. Parenchyma, colenchyma, sclerenchyma. Parenchyma, the cell wall is very thin. You can see the cells of it. The cell walls are very thin and encloses a dense cytoplasm and it contains a small nucleus. So in this figure you can see it clearly, but all the cells contains nucleus and dense cytoplasm is present. Now there are spaces, you can see white spaces here. These spaces are called intercellular spaces. Okay.
So this is the characteristic of parenchyma cell, intercalary space. And they are living cells. They are living cells, and they can divide. They have the power of dividing. Living and dividing cells. They are found in the stems, roots, leaves, flowers, and fruits. Coming on to its function, parenchyma serves as a packing tissue. It helps in packing. Parenchyma forms main support to the stem. It gives support. Parenchyma serves as food storage also. In those tissues where the food is stored, it also helps in transport of materials. So you have to learn the functions of parenchyma. Other functions of parenchyma are, it allows in gaseous exchange. It stores waste products of plants. Now, if chloroplast is present in parenchyma, then that tissue is called chlorenchyma. Okay, a parenchyma with a chloroplast is called chlorenchyma. And what is its function? Its function is photosynthesis. And if in parenchyma's air cavities are present, then that particular parenchyma is called aerenchyma. In hydrophytes, what is hydrophytes? Plants that lives in water. In hydrophytes, large air cavities are present and these are called aerenchyma. What is the function of this aerenchyma? It helps to provide buoyancy to plants. It helps the plants to float on water. Now next is colenchyma. Colenchyma, in the figure you can see, these are living cells and they are characterized by the deposition of extracellulose at the corner of the cells. So if you consider this as one of the cell, these corners will be thickened. All the corners will be thickened in colenchyma. Right? So next cell nearby, every cells will be having the corner thickening. This is the specialty of colenchyma cells. And you can see there are no space in between cells. This is one cell, another cell. There is no space in between the cells. Intercalary spaces are absent. What is the function of colenchyma? It is a mechanical tissue. So therefore, it provides mechanical support and elasticity to the plant. So that means it allows bending of plants. If a plant is bent, it should not break fast, right? It should not break. So this mechanical support is provided by colenchyma. Some cells of colenchyma also have chloroplast. So those cells having chloroplast, they helps in making sugar and starch. Now next type of tissue is sclerenchyma. So these are dead cells. Till now we were learning all the cells are living, but this sclerenchyma, they are dead cells and the walls are greatly thickened. You can see here these dark green color, right? The walls are greatly thickened with the deposition of lignin. Now, with what it is made? Lignin. The walls are made up of lignin, and there are no space. Here also you can see all the cells are compactly arranged with no spaces, no intercellular spaces. And further, sclerenchyma are of two types, sclerets and fibers.
Sclerets, you can see, they consist of very long, narrow, thick and lignified cell. In the figure you can see, the round shape is the scleret. And what are fibers? They are usually pointed. They are pointed at both the ends. So you have only to learn what is scleret. You don't have to learn much about scleret and fiber. Only the shape you need to learn. Now, you have seen coconut, right? Coconut is made up of sclerenchymatous tissue. So, what is the function of sclerenchyma? Mechanical and protective function.
Next is protective tissue. There are of three types: epidermis, cork, and stomata. Epidermis is one cell thick
and is covered with cuticle. Okay, epidermis is the outer layer of a plant, whether it be leaves, the outer covering is called epidermis, or the stem, whatever is outer skin surface of the plant is called epidermis, and it is made up of cuticle. What is cuticle? It is a waterproof waxy layer and it is made up of cutin. So if you take a plant, any stem part, if you see, you can see it has a glazy nature, and that is cuticle or waxy nature. If you put water, the water will not go inside. It has a waxy coating, and this coating is made up of cuticle. The cells of the epidermis are elongated and flattened and do not contain any intercellular space. So here in this figure you can see all these cells are elongated. They are elongated and are flattened and does not have any interspace. There is no space in between the cells. The epidermis is to protect the plant from desiccation and infection. Now, next protective tissue is cork. As plants grow older, the epidermis undergoes certain changes. The cells of cork cambium are rectangular and the cells of cork are dead. So, here you can see these are the epidermal cells. So when these epidermal cells grow older, new cells forms again outside, right? So these cells go inside. Again, when these cells are older, again new cells are formed. So these cells, which are interiormost, are called the cork. And they are also rectangular in shape and they are dead cells. Okay, they are not living cells, they are dead cells. And the walls of the cork cells are heavily thickened with what? With suberin. And that makes the cells impermeable for water and gases. So cork cells, they are thickened so that water or gas does not pass through them, and cork cell prevents desiccation, infection,
and mechanical injury. Next protective tissue is a stomata. Epidermis of a leaf has small pores and these are called stomata. So if you see the leaves, okay, if you say the outer covering of the outer surface of the leaf, that is the epidermis. On the epidermis you can see stomata, and these stomata helps in the exchange of gases, exchange of water, is helping transpiration. Now stomata, how stomata is formed? Stomata is formed of two guard cells. These are called guard cells. Okay, they are kidney shaped guard cells. Okay, there are two guard cells. In the case of dicot, they are this kidney shaped. Okay, and if it is monocot, they are dumbbell shaped. You might have seen dumbbells, right? Two dumbbells, if it is there. This is the shape of the stomata in monocot. So these cells are called guard cells. Okay, guard cells. There are two guard cells. Now, as I said, just consider the example of monocot. So there are two kidney shaped guard cells and this particular place is called the pore. Okay, pore. So this pore can open and close. In this figure you can see the pore is closed, right? These two are kidney shaped but the pore is closed. Depending upon the opening and closing of the stomata, the gases are exchanged. Which gases are exchanged? Yeah, carbon dioxide is taken out and oxygen is released. So, what is the function of stomata? It helps in gaseous exchange during photosynthesis and respiration. Now we will learn about complex tissues. What are the different types of complex tissues? Xylem and phloem. So xylem and phloem, they are also known as vascular tissues. Okay, as I said earlier, what is xylem? Xylem helps in the transport of water, right? So xylem is composed of four different types of cells. They are tracheids, vessels, xylem parenchyma and xylem sclerenchyma. Here you can see these are the figures of xylem. So except parenchyma, all other xylem elements, that is tracheids, vessels, xylem, sclerenchyma, they all are dead and have a wall which is thick and lignified. Now vessels, they are shorter and wider than tracheids and they are also long tube-like structures. Tracheids are elongated cells with tapering ends. You can see the ends are tapered. Here the ends are tapered. They also conduct water. Now since tracheids do not have open ends, water has to pass from cell to cell via pits. So there are no opening at the ends. So how will the water go? Water will move through this small pits. These holes are called pits. Now, what are the function of xylem? The main function of xylem is to carry water and minerals. As I already said, it helps in the carrying of water and mineral salts upward from the root to different parts of the shoots. And it also provides mechanical strength. Now next, complex permanent tissue is phloem. So as I already said, phloem, it helps in the transport of food materials. And it consists of different parts, sieve tubes, companion cells, phloem parenchyma, and phloem fibers. So first one, sieve tubes. Sieve tubes are slender tube-like structures and they are composed of elongated thin-walled cells placed end to end. Okay. Their end walls are perforated by numerous pores and are called sieve plates. So sieve tubes, they are found one above the other. They are slender also, and in between they have plate like structure with holes in it. Okay, perforated means with a lot of holes, and that plate is called sieve plates. Next is companion cells. Those are small, thin-walled cells containing dense and active cytoplasm and large and elongated nucleus. This is the characteristic of companion cell. The cell are small and thin-walled. Cytoplasm is dense and nucleus is elongated. And that's for all for the class regarding plant tissues. I'll be posting another video on animal tissues. Thank you. Have a great day.